Hello and welcome to another video. I hope that you are all very well. Today I'd like to talk about speeding. Should drivers be educated on the risks of speeding, or should they be forcefully be prevented from speeding in the first place? However, before I go on any further, I just want to say a big thank you to all our current subscribers, because without you guys, this video today would not be possible. If you are watching the channel and you're not a subscriber, then you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button right now. So one, you don't miss out on our future videos, and two, you support the channel at the same time. So let's talk about speeding. From the 6th of July, that's this year, 2024, all new cars sold in the EU and Northern Ireland will be fitted with something called intelligent speed assistance technology. The UK has currently decided to opt out of the scheme. However, most manufacturers in the UK have decided that from the 6th of July, they will be installing this technology into their vehicles. So, if a driver decides to go over the legal speed limit, this technology, the Intelligent Speed Assistance Technology, in other words, the ISA technology, will start beeping at the driver to notify them that they are over the speed limit. Furthermore, the steering wheel will start vibrating and pressure of the accelerator will automatically be reduced, forcefully bringing the speed limit down. As the UK has opted out of the scheme, the UK drivers will have the opportunity of switching off the technology on every journey. However, it will default will be on. So the technology will be on, and if a driver wants to switch it off, they have the option of switching it off on every journey. These cars fitted with the ISA technology will have forward facing cameras, which will be able to read road signs, speed signs, and notify the vehicle what the speed is. Furthermore, the vehicle will also be connected to the GPS mapping data, so combined it should be able to have accurate data. There is very little news out there about this technology. This is probably because both the government and the media are more concerned about people claiming disability benefits rather than anything else. Anyway, let's not get sidetracked and let's talk about some of the advantages and the disadvantages of this ISA technology. One of the biggest advantages with this technology is that it will help drivers to stay within the speed limit, therefore preventing accidents which may be caused by speeding. Another advantage is that it could save some drivers fuel. Currently, you get some drivers who increase their speed between every speed camera. So they're increasing speed and then braking hard for the speed camera and then increasing speed again. However, by driving at a constant speed within the legal speed limit, the vehicle will give better fuel consumption. And another advantage is that because these drivers, or us drivers, will not be able to legally go over the speed limit, the risk of getting speeding tickets, penalties, is virtually zero. So if you can't go over the speed limit, then you can't get a speeding ticket. So those were some of the advantages, but what about the disadvantages? Everything that has an advantage also has a disadvantage. Whether you are a learner driver or an experienced driver, you may have experienced occasion where your sat nav or even your vehicle will tell you one speed, but the speed of the road is actually different. I've experienced it myself, driving on a 40 mile an hour dual carriageway, and my vehicle tells me that the speed limit is 20 miles per hour because it has picked up a speed sign which is meant to be for the side road and not the main road. So just imagine the situation where your vehicle picks up the sign from a side road and is forcing you to drive at 20 miles an hour when the speed limit is actually 40 miles per hour on the road. So this can be potentially dangerous. However, my car has forward facing cameras and it reads the signs, but it is not connected to the GPS mapping data. So it doesn't have this additional information that may make a lot of difference. Another disadvantage that could possibly exist is if the driver in front, let's say, was driving 5 miles an hour under the legal speed limit. So you're driving on a 40 mile an hour road and this vehicle in front is driving at, let's say, 35 miles per hour. In order for you to overtake this vehicle safely, you would need to increase your speed to about 10 miles per hour more than what the vehicle in front is doing. And if you do decide to overtake, you may struggle with that. So those are some of the advantages and disadvantages. As mentioned earlier on in the video, the ISA technology is becoming law in Europe and in Northern Ireland as from the 6th of July. However, the UK government has decided to opt out. Why is this? Why do you think that the UK government has opted out? Is it because they're making too much revenue from speeding drivers and they are concerned that if they participate in this scheme that they're going to lose this revenue? Or is it that they just want to be different from the EU? Now, the UK struggled to come out of the EU because we didn't want to obey their laws. And now the EU have decided on this law and the UK may be thinking, oh, let's just be a little bit different and not participate in the scheme. London Transport has already got the intelligent speed assist technology fitted on all their vehicles and have had it for some time. Whatever your opinion is, I would love to know. So please comment in the text below. Tell me why you think that the government has decided to opt out. And also, if you did have this technology fitted in your vehicle, would you use it or would you not use it? And why would you use it and why would you not use it? Until next time, take care. Bye-bye.